In the wake of Hurricane Dorian in 2019, the IDB is helping to rebuild damaged energy infrastructure in a way that makes it more resilient and sustainable. While repairing the main electrical systems, an interim solution allows power to be restored more quickly to communities.
Not only was the infrastructure, electrical infrastructure, was taken out, but the roadways was still, you couldn't get where you needed to go, and you had no power. The people who were separated had no power. So these microgrids will be put into various communities and tied back to the grid. We will be able to restore electrical services to these communities until the main network is reconstructed.
Stanford Moss coordinates the reconstruction with resilience in the energy sector in the Bahamas project, an IDB loan approved in the aftermath of Hurricane Dorian.
The system had to be redesigned with some redundancy in it. What that means is, rather than have one line of, say, 34 kilovolts of electricity, we will make two. One will go on a steel pole that's capable of withstanding winds of up to 180 miles an hour. So we'll create a dual circuit. That's part of the resiliency and hardening of the equipment. Stronger poles, stronger cables, thicker cables.
Accelerated by Hurricane Dorian, a key focus of the project is also transitioning the country to renewable energy.
In addition to that, the program calls for support and integrating of renewable energy sources or technologies into the islands. And right now we're looking at solar rooftop photovoltaic systems for government buildings. And of course, that is focusing on the sustainability of the renewable program.
This includes establishing a renewable energy entity.
That entity will be tasked with promoting and future development and of renewables throughout the country.
Renewable energy and resilience are paramount to sustainable development in the Bahamas and for the people in the face of climate-related disasters.
And so if there is anything that we can do now to lessen the impact on the lives of people, even though all of the investments we keep talking about rebuilding and reconstructing, but you know, we don't talk about reconstructing the lives of people, which is fundamental to all of this.